Top dog by the mall, yeah, I'm burning it up. DPGC, you should be turning it up. CPT, LBC. Yeah, YouTube, this is MilesGaming67, and today I'm gonna be doing a build on the Aether Sword. Is okay, I mean, it's kind of low tier, so if you're like rank 4, rank 5, rank 6-ish, I guess you should get it. But if you're anything above, I don't really recommend it. If you really want it, then you can get it, but you're wasting your time and energy ranking up and stuff. But yeah, this weapon can deal radiation damage on impact from a drop-in attack. So if you jump and then do an attack, then it will inflict the radiation damage on the enemy. Stats for this thing are kind of weak, but with mods you can make them better. And yeah, there are better options out there, but this is just an unpopular weapon. Not many people use it, so I hope you guys enjoyed this build and like what I did. As you can see from this gameplay, I'm wrecking low-level enemies so hard, dude. And they're just dying like 1-2 slashes, similar to how OP the Dragon Nakana is. If you haven't seen that video, you should go ahead and watch it. But anyways, enough of that. This weapon can be used in high-tier planets and like asteroids and dwarf planets such as Pluto and Sedna, but I really don't recommend it, because it's gonna be taking you a crap ton of time killing it. And especially if you're trying to go on Hierarchon Pluto and you're trying to rank it up, just don't go there. Just go to Helen Saturn. Much better option, and you still get a decent amount of XP. But yeah, let's just get to the mods. So I have two config builds. The Yi Foundation helped me make this. And I got pressure point for base damage, then fury for speed. This is why I made the intro, okay? I like calling this weapon the Eugene Okay weapon, because once you got these speed mods on it, it's extremely fast and it feels like you have Genji's ult but like on steroids. Anyways, Berserker for extra speed damage, then Molten Impact for heat damage, and Shocking Touch for electricity damage. And this combination adds on to the radiation damage, so it's pretty nice. Then Jagged Edge, then True Steel, then Valiant Scourge, which just gives you more elemental. Now, if you don't really like this build, then you don't kill a lot of if you don't kill a lot of Grineer and Corpit, I mean Infested, sorry, then you can use this build, which is a little bit better, but it could still be used against Corpus, but yeah, it's average, it's alright. But anyways, the only thing I've done here is I switched out some of the elemental stuff and added Primed Heavy Trauma. You could just use the regular one, but I like the Primed versions. It's a lot better. But anyways, I made Corrosive Blast Damage to make it a little bit more effective. And Blast Damage seems to do a pretty good amount of damage on all races and species in this Warframe universe. Some other acknowledgements I'd like to make is how it's really good for killing Infested, so use it for that. And Grineer, it's okay, but don't use it on Corpus. I mean, you can, but like in my gameplay I was using it on Corpus, but I mean it's not gonna be too effective, especially on high Corpus levels where there's shields everywhere itching to rape you at any second, anytime, anywhere. But yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe and all that. And I do space gameplay, Warframe guides and stuff. And I may be doing Overwatch and Breath of the Wild soon. But I don't really know. But yeah, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video.